Hey guys, this is B-Run. Welcome to Let's Hack FF6, where everything's made up and the points don't matter. That's right, the points are like bidding on the chocobo at the auction house. It doesn't matter. You're not going to get that chocobo. The little kid's going to get it every single time. So how's everybody doing tonight? Good to be here. I'm happy to be here. I hope you're happy to be here. So tonight, we're going to be doing some debugging. Okay, so this is a very boring thing to do, but is it a very, very important skill to have? And I was chatting with some people on Discord this week, and I found out that some people don't debug. They just try to figure out what they did wrong, and that doesn't really help. It does to an extent, but you're going to find your mistakes way, way faster if you actually use a debugger. So what we're going to be using is Geiger's debugger for SNES 9X, and that's just the one that I use. I know that BSNES also has allegedly a good one. I have not used it myself, but I believe other people on here have. I'm assuming these concepts are going to carry over. So, actually, first of all, let me show you what's going on. And you notice that I left the music running today. Is it still running? Okay, maybe I didn't. Maybe it stopped. There it is. So I'm going to show you actually what's been going on. And I don't know how long it's going to take because it's totally random. Aha, there it is. That didn't take very long. I'm stuck in some random infinite post-battle loop. So, this is what we're going to fix today. At least we're going to try. I don't know. I'm really good at breaking things and not finding it for, like, months. So, we've got some stuff. That's mine. But before we get into that, a couple other things. This is my documentation for the magic update. It's coming along. I'm showing you the nice looking part here, because once we get down to C2, it starts getting bad. Don't worry, it's all gonna get annotated. It's just gonna take forever. Anyway, this is gonna show off Blitz and Retort. You know what? I think my computers have different alignments for like tabs and stuff. Oh, maybe I didn't do anything with this. Never mind. This stuff keeps happening between when I use this computer and when I use my laptop. They're both using the same program, so I don't know why that is. Anyway, so I move Blitz to Retort, Retort to Blitz, rather. If you guys want to see that, why aren't the debugger stuff popping up right away? I'm not using that one today. Oh, that's right, they're over here. Ha. Guys, let me know if you're getting a lot of buffering today with the stream, because I've seen it a couple times already on mine. I might just drop my Twitch window, but hey, Kyuga, glad you can make it, and everyone else. All right, so never get tired of seeing that screen. So Retort now works on Blitz, because I'm not going to have Wedge use it, I'm going to have Vargas use it. And so I'll show you that real quick, because it's only going to take a minute, and it's something I did. And so at least there's at least one new thing before I go into serious debugging. Okay, good. These guys even hit me. They may kill themselves first. So it works exactly the way that you would expect it to. There are a couple different places you actually have to grab it, though. So he uses it, he backs up, and we just gotta sit there until he gets hit. Hopefully he does it fast. I'm gonna just tap the fast forward button here. There it is. It'll still do it even if there's a choco block. Ta-da! And it did it! Ta-da! Hooray! Woo! Everyone's like, what's the big deal? It was actually a little bit of a pain to move. So the original code sits in guts, and it's all right here. And I should pull up the original so you can see a little bit of that, because I had to actually implement it a totally different way. Which is fine, because Blitz actually had a neat way I could account for the changes without doing quite all the same stuff. So, in the game disassembly, this is what it looks like in under Sword Tech. So what it does is checks to see if it's Sword Tech 01 is retort. Well, you don't have to. You can still set. All you have to do, if you do that, just cap the damage at 9999. That is totally doable. Okay? Kyuga, go download the whatever it is, the 3200 damage patch or whatever the heck it's called. I don't even remember where I got it, but I do have the copy of the patch if you need it. So, install it, and then just make sure you keep your damage cap at 9999. You can still set your own damage cap. It's going to be as simple as changing 2 bytes. 2 bytes in the ROM. And that'll make sure you're saying, hey, Jetty for me, glad you could make it today. So anyway, the retort code. So it branches if it's not retort. And then it sets up a whole bunch of parameters for the spell. And this isn't actually for retort. All the stuff it's setting up right here, all the way down to where it branches to 1882, which is the jump to the display code. Yeah, it's super simple, Kyuga. I will show you. I can show you in my code, and actually I can probably show you in here. Because the damage cap is already set. Because naturally the game would just use whatever number comes out, right? And so the game actually has to artificially limit the damage to keep it at 9999, so it doesn't go over, and so that it doesn't, you know, whatever else. So that part just basically stays the same. And I don't know if what is it? 16-bit damage or whatever patch. I don't know what to call it. 32,000 damage patch. I feel like I should know the name, but I don't. So, anyway. So, I think the patch will automatically lift the limit for you. And all you have to do is just put it back in. But it's really, really, really easy. Anyway. So, all the stuff is setting up here, it's manually setting up the skill. Because when it loads the skill, it's going to set a whole bunch of things that you set up from the spell data. Well, what this is doing is it's basically overwriting all of that or replacing it by setting up everything manually for it and basically making it a nothing. It makes it nothing. I don't know why it sets the magical damage, why it sets it to can't be dodged, because this one right here that it's setting up right here is the one where Cyan just steps forward and goes whoop. And then he steps back and that's it. That's all this is. Because when you come back around the second time and you compare, it gets down to here where it's checking to see if you're entering the code. It enters this code once when he sets it up and then once when he performs it. So it gets down to here and it shifts the bit into the carry. And that tells the game that it's ready to execute. So it skips all this setup stuff that it did and comes down here to do the last little bit, I guess, of setup and then goes in and does a move. Okay, so it does a lot of manual setup. What? Oh, man. What do we got over here? Is this something I should click on? Hey, DN. Good to see you. It's not 24-bit damage, but that's, I think, isn't that what it says? I feel like that's what I have in my, but I know that's wrong, because 24-bit damage is like 16 million or something like that. It's humongous. It's not that hard to make something that's not beatable. It's a lot harder to make a boss that is difficult, but not too difficult. Like, proper game balance. Yeah, it's 32,000 damage. Well, it wouldn't be 32,000K, because that would be 32,000. So it's 32,000 damage. Okay? My goodness, people. Anyway. So instead of going through all that mess, I did something a little bit different. Because the Blitz code already has a way to basically null its own attack type with the incorrect Blitz input. And all it does is it changes the ability to what is normally pummel, eye gouge for me, and sets a parameter that tells it to display the incorrect Blitz input and clears your targets. And when it clears the targets, and this is something I actually used in the Monster AI upgrade, when I wanted to have an ability that would show its name but not do anything, I would basically set no valid targets. It would have to set a target that was not a valid target, and that would allow it to show the spell name but not do the attack. And I needed that for the monster that I was doing it with, because he ran on a cycle, and so you needed to know where he was in the cycle. So if he used an attack, even if no one was there to get hit by it, it still needed to display it. And so that's all it's doing here. It's basically making the an invalid target, clearing the valid targets, and then setting a message to display. Okay, and these were actually normally the other way around. It's first it set the targeting, and then cleared the targeting, and then it set the message to display, and I swapped those. And we'll get to the reason why in a second. And then it comes through and does the rest of its stuff. All right? And then I created the retort check here. Man, this is ugly. This is so ugly. Why is it like this? I need to fix everything. My OCD is driving me nuts right now. Okay. So, what I decided to do. So we're comparing it to the new ability, spell ability, that the spell ID for it. And you guys are still going on about that. Kuga, don't worry, I have the patch. I have the patch all by its lonesome. Here, I will show you. Where am I at? I'm in the Children of Vector, so I want, what am I doing? Documentation, my code. I believe that's it right there. But that might actually be the monster one. That's the monster one. That's the monster one. Hold on. Got it somewhere. Overkill. I've got it right here. Okay? I will get that uploaded for you somewhere. And you can have it. Okay? There it is, safe and sound. It has not disappeared into the abyss of the internet. Okay. So, for my check, what I had it do, instead of setting up all that stuff, now it's still toggling the bit to check to see if it's ready to attack and everything else. But what I did that's different was that instead of doing all that setup, all I had it do was jump back into here so that it would clear the target and set it for eye gouge so that he would step forward. Now it still displays the correct... It still displays the correct message. It still says counter. And that's because of this, that it still displays counter. And that's the special code for retort. So you know how you can set the special properties? That's the one for retort. And so that needs to be set in order to make certain other things work properly. And this has to do with display, I guess, because this right here sets it to do the blitz animation. And then this right here shows it what is the displayed attack. Okay. So instead of doing all that manual setup, all I had to do was come back out to where Blitz already knew how to create a null attack and do that. And then when it comes back through, it's able to pass through like a normal attack and it pulls all of its own properties and does its thing. All right, so that's how Blitz retort works. And then the other piece was the special code for the retort ability that you set. So this is in the code for Blitz, for the Blitz command set. And then this is the special code for that. And those are really the only two things you have to worry about. And then I just cleared it all out of Sortek. So you guys can move it to anything you want. You can set it to any attack number you want. It's actually not that hard. Okay. Mixing tabs in space? What do you mean? Am I doing something wrong? All right, well, let's get to debugging. I'm going to hop back out. And thanks to... So we're going to talk a little bit of best practices here. Backups, and I have showed this off a little bit. In the past. My indents. Yeah, I know, exactly my point. I'm not mixing them. They're already mixed, and I'm trying to unmix them. Is the thing. It's blah, blah, blah. I don't like it. That's what I'm doing back in the magic document. I'm fixing everything so that it just uses tabs. Tabs only. But it didn't look that bad on my laptop. On my laptop, for some reason, everything lined up better. But whatever. So, it's not going to look like that later. Alright, so... best practices for backups. This is what I do. And I'm going to go ahead and say that it's the best practice, okay? I keep dated backups... And along with my dated backups, I keep a history of every change I make. Or every change that's not like one byte. Sometimes I put those in, sometimes I leave them out. Depending on how minor it is. But 99% of the time, literally everything will go in here, okay? So I keep dated backups of everything that I do. Okay? So I don't want to show you guys everything. But, man, this is all back in 2013. Oh, man. Back in the day. All right. And then a mysterious two-year gap. But we're not talking about that. All right. So due to some... me just going back through the ROM. So what I did was I discovered that this was a thing. I was like, okay, so where does this start becoming a thing? And what I started doing was going back through each of my copies at random points and doing battles over and over and over again to try to repeat the bug to find out where the bug existed, okay? So you have to be able to repeat the bug. Okay, so you repeat the bug, then you find out what the first instance of where that bug appeared was, all right? So as of... my 7.5 backup, it worked. Everything was fine. Okay? And this was where I was really scared. It had to do with my map expansion. I was really worried about that. But that didn't do it because I sat for an extremely long time on this one trying to get it to trigger and it would not do it. And then I flipped over here to 7.16 and it did it relatively quickly. Okay? So I started reading through these, trying to figure out what it might be that did it. Okay. Exits doesn't really matter. Some sprite stuff doesn't matter. A lot of stuff that didn't matter. Okay. Two things stuck out to me. My splash screen. I moved the image that I did when I made my new splash screen to the FF bank because it is a much, much larger image. No, it's not actually. It's in C1. And sometimes it gets past that. sometimes it gets past that point when it goes to where the screen starts to fade and then it stops. But the whatever the loop is, it's in C1. Now I will go back and check on some of that stuff. And so one of my thoughts was maybe this image is maybe using more RAM than the game thinks it should be able to, and something doesn't get cleared out, and eventually something gets stuck. I don't know. That's one thought I have. And the other one was that this is when I did my my trance stuff. And so I did a lot of things. Well, I didn't do the magic patch. The magic patch is not in Children of Vector yet. So that is not it. That is definitely not it. Those are all fair assumptions. And you guys are thinking in the right direction, which is good. Like, this is good. You're thinking in the right direction, you're just wrong. All right. Children of Vector, backups. All right, so this is where I know it appears. This is where I know it starts happening. I didn't copy my saves folder. Crap. Hold on. Might have to create one. And you know, it's not that big a deal. It's a lot easier to do in the save L'Oreal sequence than anywhere else. Yeah, you don't even have a thing here. Hold on. All right, we're gonna go back to my saves. Shouldn't I have one that says save states also? No, that's all in here too. Never mind. All right, let me find one. I have a lot of things. You know that? First of all, let's get rid of that. 716. We're just going to rename this 71616, right? All right, let's relaunch it. All right, so I don't have the save state where I want it. Don't have a save state where I want it, but I can get there relatively quickly. I apologize for this. I have the proper save state on my laptop, and I forgot to transfer it. All right, let's see if I can. Problem is, I can't navigate very well in fast forward, so that's not going to save me a whole lot of time. In the time it would have taken me to do that, I could have done what I did anyway. So, yeah, I know it's the new keyboard's loud. It's a really nice keyboard, but in order to hear me well, I've got to keep the mic relatively close to my face, and my controller was having issues. So you're going to be hearing the clickety click. Almost there. All right. I'm going to go ahead and make a save state just to make sure any of the things I do in here. Tapping relaxes you. Huh. That's really interesting. Have you ever heard of ASMR, Mog? Tapping is a very prevalent trigger for a lot of people. It's autonomous sensory meridian response. It's like a tingly feeling in the back of your head. Oh, look, I got stuck. So, no, ASMR. ASMR. Seriously, put it into YouTube. It's going to blow your mind. In fact, put in ASMR tapping if tapping is the thing for you. Yeah, so I'm stuck, but let me show you. So we're going to step into it, and this is pretty commonplace. I'm going to stay in C1 forever. I haven't gotten all the way through the loop before. But one of the things it's doing is it's checking a C2 address. Now, these haven't changed, so I don't believe this is where it is. I just think this is where it spends the most time. Yeah, but it'll loop through this like a bunch of times, but it will eventually get past it. But this is one of the places it loops back to, and it spends the most time here. Oh, look, CO is already at the end of the 100 million loops. So I'm not sure how far to go with it. But this isn't actually how I'm going to do it. What I'm actually going to do for this problem is I'm going to go back, I'm going to create some copies, and I'm going to make my changes again one by one. I just need to get a proper save state. So unfortunately, this happened before I was ready for it. It's a good thing I got my save state though, right? Yeah, it's definitely when I'm trying to leave battle. And like I said, sometimes it happens right as the screen does its first level of fade. So the screen will just be slightly dim and then it'll stop. But the game doesn't freeze. It keeps processing the sprite changes for all that. Of course it does. Come on. I just want to get... You know, I wonder if it's happening on the same number. Like, look. Aha, I got through it that time. Here, save state. But it seems to be cumulative. Like, it seems like the further I go, the more likely it is to start happening. And that's what makes me think that it could be something akin to a RAM leak. Oh, no. Oh, wait, never mind. This is one of the backups that has the layer 2 missing. I have not modified my RNG. All right. So I have my save state that I want now. In fact, I'm going to save two of them just in case. All right. So this is what we're going to do. Open up a new one of these. And this is what I do when I have to debug something major that happened a while ago. If you're debugging like certain code that you're working with, if you already know where you're trying to go, come on. And hope maybe we'll get that far. If you already know where you're going, that you need to walk through something, you just set an address and then you start stepping through. In fact, I would like to do more in-depth stuff on that. I might have to do that next week, depending on what we get through here, because I'm actually trying to find my problem here. Going here, it's going to my backups. And so I'm gonna start with 7.5 here. And I'm gonna make a copy of it. Okay, and normally I would just leave it here, but for purposes of being clear, someone tell me if I spelled that wrong. We get a quarantine copy. 7, 16. And I'll just work in here. Okay. So open width should be a thing. What? Where's HXD? Ah. No, I don't always want to do it with the same thing. Dagnabbit. I just want to have an open with HXD option. All right. Here we are in our code. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start comparing things. And I'll just make changes just a little bit at a time and find out when it breaks. All right. So so the one that we're going to be working with, where we're going to be actually making changes to, is the 7.5.16 copy. So real quick here in my saves, that save state, this one right here, I'm going to go ahead and rename that 7.5.16-copy. Is that how that is? Dash copy. I don't know if it's case sensitive. Probably not, but I'm going to do it anyway. And just to verify, no, not that. Not that one. I want, what am I doing? I want this. I want this emulator. All right, so back up, quarantine. And real quick to verify, we're gonna go ahead. We're gonna see if I can get this to trigger here. Oh man, I'm getting wrecked. Yeah, the other save file that I used, I can't believe I lived. Oh my goodness. Did you see him survive? What a stud. Hey, you can kind of see there's something down there. All right. All right, so as you can see, it's doesn't seem to be triggering. Now, I had some instances where it took a little while. Oh, hey, Lady Door, good to see you. Glad you can make it. All right, so it definitely doesn't seem like it's happening here. All right, we're definitely not getting the same error. All right, I think that's pretty well verified. So let's start making changes. So we're gonna go back to the documentation and we're gonna start changing things. Here we go. There's one change. I can't imagine how that would do anything. So we're just gonna go to that location. What was it? C2 4 C E7. So 2 4 E E 7. You know what? I don't even know what that does. I don't remember now. So what did I do different? I don't even remember now. Oh, yeah. I've gotten so used to adding the header in my brain that I guess that's why they call it a header, right? Add it in your head. Yeah. Clever. That's what you guys have come to expect on this stream. Yeah, exactly. Well, yeah, and that's why I didn't think that was part of it. And well, and I was worried it was because that's such a major change. So what did I do over here? Actually, I just need to compare it. So let's do this. File compare, compare. Let's go to the two. All right. This actually has to do with my splash screen. Actually, yeah, let's do the splash screen because that's one of the ones I actually think it might be. Okay, so let's go here. Next thing's not until there, which is, what is that? Oops, hold on. I changed the wrong one. The 6.5 copy is the one that I want to change. No, 6.16 copy. No, 6.5. Forget I said anything. Let's start that over again. This one. I'm used to changing the one up top. I don't know why. I'm changing the one that's up top. All right, so there we go. And that's telling me where to go for the rest of the stuff. So let's go to, this is trance stuff, I think. I don't want that. I think I successfully moved everything. I think I can start here and just grab the rest of the ROM, and that should do all of my F4. No, this is trance. This is old trance stuff. That's old trance stuff. Some of that may have gotten overwritten at some point. Wait, how is this one up top now? This one I changed at the beginning. Seven five is the copy that needs to change. Why do I keep changing the wrong one? 10. 10. Okay. Yeah, well, the splash screen caused me problems before too when I was trying to expand because it was in the way of other stuff. Now, nothing I did over here should have gotten in the way of that. The only other thing I was thinking is if it was just taking up so much space in the RAM that it was cutting into stuff that the game needed at some point. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna grab everything from here, from the F5 bank. Which this still needs to get relocated. I don't think I have ever done that. So I'm going to grab everything from here all the way down to the end of the ROM. And we're going to go to the same place here. All right, I think that's all I need to do to get the splash screen. I think everything else was in that back end there. So let's load it back up and see if I get the right splash screen. I do. Which makes me wonder, actually, if I load the save state, if that will even do it. Well, look at that. You know, this actually means something. Look at that. That has never happened before. Well, it's not doing it now. Okay. Well, we might have found it. Actually, no, that's part of a break. What else did I change? Let me see what else maybe I did in that change. Let me hop over to my history. It might be a loading error if I changed the No, never mind. That wasn't with an expansion thing. All right, so what I'm gonna do. Yeah, I don't see anything else in there. So what I'm gonna do is reset that, and I'll start from the save point. I did something wrong. I did something wrong. Which is interesting because it gets this far and then it blows up. Chocobo block is a replacement for dog block. Huh. All right, I missed something associated with the splash screen. What did I miss on the splash screen? The change that I made with this had to do with the logic on what attacks to do after the block. I actually changed the chocobo to be blocking a long, long time ago. All right. See, this is why we do this stuff. Oops, not that one. Not that one. So I might need, I think I have documentation on that. I think I've got something for the splash screen. Here we go. Yeah, so 40. All my changes in there. Is that really? Oh, that was just for the one piece. Huh. So what in the world did I do? It actually is 255 colors or less. It just uses like a whole bunch of one. I did. It's humongous, but I need it. I need it. I'm gonna fill most of it up too, I'm pretty sure. With expanded stuff. Oh man. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what I missed there. So let's bring this back up. Maybe it was when I was doing this back and forth. Ten. This has to do with the splash screen. Okay. I don't have any other. I don't have anything else until 2A90. And I'm not sure what that is. This is expanded stuff. Oh, okay. I screwed up my map loader. I did change some stuff in here. Look at that. Something in D9. So that actually does need to get changed. That's what happened. I screwed up my map loader. So apparently I changed something else. Move some other stuff around. Now this is, and that's interesting because this is the later copy here. So what did I move? You know, it's probably whatever it is probably moved back now too. Move back again. Or I could do it again and skip the stuff that is, that's what I'll do. That's what I'll do. Because if it is map loader related, because now I see I did another thing related to maps that I did not do before. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make sure I skip the map stuff. So I'm going to instead... Oh, any changes to my maps? I would need to change my pointers and my maps. I see. All right, so I'm going to go back to here, and I'm actually only going to copy through the stuff. Come on. I'll copy through to right here. Because I don't think I've got anything in 4.2 or anything like that. I think I condensed it all into around the 4.0 bank. And that should keep me from screwing up my map loader. All right, we're going to give that a shot. Let's see if we get past the loading screen. Do your thing. There we go. All right, map loader's working. I need to make sure I'm opening it in the right with the debugger. All right, now we can finally get to testing this properly. All right. All right, let's see if it goes. Sometimes it would take me a while, so I'm not gonna quit just yet. I'm more inclined to believe it has to do with my transcode, because that's where I actually was changing those kinds of things. So I think we're in the clear here. Oh, whoops. I mean, occasionally it would take longer than this, but not normally. And you saw what it was doing with this exact setup. Okay. Yeah. That's interesting. There's still an invisible sprite running around. I always had problems with this. I needed to change. I think a couple of the guys were running too fast and it screwed stuff up. Anyway, I'm pretty sure. Oops. I don't seem to be getting it. Now my trance changes were a little bit more complex. So I'm gonna have to figure that out. Let me go to where that is. In fact, let me do everything except trance. Let me make sure I ruled everything else out and then do my trance changes, because that should be around the only thing that happens. With the exception of maybe this here. All right, so let's go ahead and make another change. We're gonna do C2. 4E7, and we'll take this ROM there. Okay, A9FC, and that's it. We're not adding care. We're not. Yeah. Okay. That's actually the only difference. Yeah, we're just loading the spell number rather than adding the spell number. All right. So that's. Should be it. All right. Okay. All right. So, based on what I can see here, The only stuff I should need to change, I should be able to grab everything in the C0 bank, which is stuff I might need for the map loader. So let's go down to, beginning of C1, all the way back to the top. Okay. Come over here, all the way to the top. Paste that in. And we'll go down. We'll start at C3. And we should be able to take that down to the... Well, and not down to the bottom, but we should be able to take that through all of the regular ROM. What I don't want to do is get into the middle F banks. Whoops. Because that's where some of my transcode sits. So I'm skipping C2 and C1 where I did trans changes and the transcode down in the F banks. Okay, so we're gonna go to that same starting location. I'll paste it in. All right. We go to the same spot. We did go to the same spot. And then the last thing is my map data, which should be, I should be fine. Everything basically past here. What is that? All right. Actually here, all the way down to the end. Wait, I need an actual location so I can use the go to. And also, I'm not using that one anyway. All right, so I'm going to go to 450200, which is where... Oh, that's right. This is where my extra sprites pop up. All right, and that should take me down to the end, and it does. All right, so if I'm right, then... We should be able to not get the bug here. So let's start by seeing if it loads. Start by seeing if the game loads. No map loader errors? I think we're good. Cool. All right. So now we need to see. Yeah, I think I was right. I think it has to do with the, I think it has to do with something I did with trance. And I was doing a lot of stuff with trance, so I'm going to have some stuff to look at. And a lot of stuff that was, like, new, also. So I wouldn't be surprised if I did something like that, where I changed a number I shouldn't have changed. I went through a lot of work to get a character to interact with the... battle scripts. I wonder if there's a certain cleanup process it has to do for the battle scripts that maybe I need to implement for characters. But all it does is it has 2 bytes that it uses to show definitely no problems. All right. And just to make sure there's no problem with the RAM, I'm gonna make sure that I go into my saves. And I'm gonna make one of these with the 616 copy to make sure that indeed this save state didn't I just make the save state for it Copy.oops. Copy. What in the world did I just do? Yeah, okay. I can't do anything. Oh, I'm just not pressing the button down right. Okay, good. See, I can still get it. I can still get it. And whatever it does, it happens in battle too. Whatever it is, it happens in battle. It's not like something that was pre-existing that I walked in with, because otherwise it would still happen. Okay. Tends to break a whole subroutine off into new space. Well, the thing is, I'm dealing with a lot of things that already exist. Give me 1 second, guys. So it's definitely something in the trance code. So let's pull up my trance stuff. Because that is next. All right. So what I revamped the whole thing. So it's got to be one of these things, I'm sure. Moving script when rage disappears. Rage and selection. Yeah, I'm gonna. Well, it'd be nice, but the problem is, I'm not sure. Actually, you know what? Maybe we should use some breakpoints and make sure that, at the very least, I'm using the correct registers. Like using the correct processor statuses. Did I even do any C1 changes? I don't know. I don't think that I did. I think everything I did was in C2. Look, and it's not even that much compared to everything else. So what's this? Get status after attack. Well, yeah, exactly. And you can do that. And you actually can do that. So the only difference left. Now, I could do one piece at a time. In fact, one of the things that I'm looking at here is there's a certain thing that runs after you get hit where it updates all your statuses. And it took me a while to find this, because what I wanted to do was find when you died for it to clear the script out. Because what the problem I was having was that even if the rage status was getting cleared by whatever means, like even if I did it manually or whatever else, just lost my train of thought. If there were bytes in that where it keeps the scripts pointer for where you're at in the script list, it would continue auto doing attacks. And so I had to find where I could turn that off if your character died or if rage went away. And so this actually has my suspicion currently, because this constantly runs when your character gets hit. Because a lot of this stuff shouldn't have gotten used, because I'm not using rage, I'm not using trance, right? But the things that do appear constantly are the ATB code and the status after attack. So let me try a couple of these changes and see if either any of these trigger it. Guessing it reads if there is an FF or not to determine if the attack should be manual. Sorry, I don't know where you're talking. Probably. Oh, are you, yeah, you're talking about in the script. Yeah. That's my guess, but I don't know. But I don't know. And I've been through a lot of that script code. There were a lot of pieces to that. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to do these one at a time. I'm going to go see what this is and see what it is exactly I changed in here. Get status after attack. So status, status to set. Status to clear, status to set. Okay, yeah. So load status to clear and change the statuses to set. So I basically just took, I think, this first one and turned it into a long, a jump to long. Okay, so somewhere in there, probably at the end, I should expect to see load AF8, test and set bit FC. Right? Did I do that at least? I did it eventually. In fact, I did the whole thing. Oh, I did that and then returned. So I did the whole thing for it right here. I copied that whole stinking thing. And it looks like my code does not change any registers. I'm not changing the processor status for X, Y, or any such thing. D 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D. And that would just go to here. Alright, so let me walk through this because I haven't looked at it actually in a while. So it loads the status byte. It rotates a bit and branches if carry is clear, which means it's checking for a certain status. Status clear for byte 4. Man, what did I even do? This is it clearing. This right here is it clearing the pointer to the attack script for the character and the pointer to the counterattack script for the character. I wonder, well, you know, I think the way I set this up was that it should check. I wonder if this is the right, because status is to clear, it says is F4, so why do I have F7 there? I mean, either way, even if it does get down here for a character, it should still be saving FFFF, so that shouldn't be a problem. And then it does the rest of this. And I do believe that we're working with the 16-bit A here. Don't go away. All right. All right. So load status byte 4, and it rotates in the status. And what it's checking for, I think, is death or something, or it's checking for rage, and if it's clear, then it goes out here. So anyone who doesn't have rage should just run this. See, I don't see a problem with this. Statuses to clear. So load statuses to clear. And checking to see if rage is a status to clear, except that's not the right thing. This should be. So hypothetically, no one in there should be getting it anyway. So I'm gonna go ahead and try to make this change. And if I can make this change, then I think I'm okay. If I can make that change and I'm still okay. And I could have just done this, but I kind of wanted to look at it. So let's go to where that is. That's F2 bank. So that's 320200. It's this one thing here. B9, F9, 3E, 6A, 90, OD, A5, F7, and I have F6 here and F7 there. F6. Okay, hold on. Do I want 6 or do I want 7? Hypothetically, that shouldn't be a thing either way. You know, it might be. If it's checking for the wrong byte here. I'm not sure which one I need. I'm going to make the change. Before I do anything, I'm just going to go ahead and make the change. Okay. So... and then C2. Ah. And then go to 2467F. And all the way down to 2467F. And let me check real quick to make sure that I was actually at the right spot. 8F is where that should be ending. 8F. Okay. All right. So we're going to try that. So again, I don't need to implement the whole thing because I know that that code's going to run one way or the other. So we'll see if we get it. So far, it doesn't appear so. Now, I had really intended to go through, use a lot more of the actual debugger. And let me go ahead and put a breakpoint in for, whoops. Let me make sure that it's actually doing that code also. Where am I at? Wrong place. I want that. All right, so this is how you set a breakpoint. C2447F, okay? So you set your address here in the breakpoint, and it's going to break upon execute. You can also do read and write. Read and write is if it's, you use that if it's data, and you can also use that to find RAM addresses, or to check RAM addresses, because RAM doesn't execute. So... if it's data you're dealing with, you want to check read or write, whether the game is reading it, whether the code is writing to it. And then if it's an address where you're doing stuff, you set your breakpoint for execute. All right. So it looks like this already runs right off the bat. And really, this shouldn't be a problem for anybody. Because nothing should be showing up in here, so it's just going to go ahead and do the whole thing and check everyone's everything. Why is this still running? How many times does that need to run? But I don't see any problems. I just wanted to make sure I was actually... it was actually going through the code. the way that I thought it should. So let me go ahead and turn off that breakpoint. Okay. And then do this just a little bit longer. I mean, you saw how quickly we found it. You saw how quickly we found it before. All right, so that piece of the code didn't do it. That piece of trance didn't do it. But we're whittling it down. You see how we started with like this whole big game worth of things? And if I didn't have my backups with my notes, there were millions of changes it could have been. Like, there would be no way for me to track this down. This is by far way easier than trying to trace the whole thing out. Okay? So I'm going to skip some of the stuff that's in the rage selection, but what I am going to do is some of the stuff in the ATB. The stuff that definitely runs, whether I use it or not. Okay? I need to see what all this is. This is a custom function because 6.6 is in the custom functions, isn't it? I do believe. Where's that getting called from? Why do I have it starred? Why didn't I finish this code? Okay. I just removed certain things from there so that wouldn't cause any issues. Right, that was just a note I made. This was something that I changed, but I can't imagine how that would be different because every other time it came in, it was already mostly there. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a couple of these minor changes, this and these here. Just to verify that they're working, just so I can cross them off the list, okay? So we're gonna go to 2.5.6.5c and OB543E543954. These might actually already be done. Some of the stuff was pre-existing. Some of this stuff was from my old trance code that still needed to exist here. And then 5.4.6.8. Oh, I'm already right next to that. 6.8 is, oh. Literally right where I left off. 11.13.02.17.0c. Okay, so that's all fine. But this other one is an actual change. And it is 2.2.f.7.4. And it was C220, which sets the accumulator to 16-bit. And the one that I have, C230, sets the accumulator and X and Y to 16-bit. The reason I had to do this was because every other time the game naturally went in there, X and Y were already 16-bit. And I'll actually show you that. Okay. So I'm going to show you what I was looking at there. Okay. Now, X and Y are already 16-bit when you come into here, but it pushes X, A, and the processor status before it does this, and it restores it all at the end because it has to. So me changing this to 230 was helpful for the commands that I was using. Okay, so it gets used the way it needs to get used, and it does get restored at the end, so I don't see any reason why that should cause problems. So, C230, and you know what, just because, I'm gonna go ahead and do it anyway. can do battle after battle, and it seems like it's doing all right. And just because I'm weird like that, I'm going to do one over here. Just so I can prove to myself that it still happens on... It's not just a fluke that I'm not getting it. It just happens almost right away as soon as I switch to this other ROM. Okay, so that wasn't it. That wasn't it. We're making our way. We're making our way down the changes. Okay. What is this? Man, I did just not... Ugh. I apologize for this mess that you have to look at here. I just did not finish this thing. And I just had stuff all over the place. Alright, so where we're at right here... okay, so this is a branch to tell you whether... That is looking to see whether this is a character or a monster. Which is why it's comparing it to 08. And so if the carry's clear, then that means it's 6-4 or... Hold on. The carry would be set if it was 8. 6-4-2 or 0. Yeah, 6-4-2 or 0, which are the IDs in battle for your four battle characters. Right. So this is a check to see if it's a character. So some of this other stuff is kind of connected. Does that mean I have this other stuff? So what exactly did I change? OD, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D. So it gets down to here. And so this is, I think, where I made my changes. So now it's checking. If it's a character, it checks for rage. And if it's rage, then it jumps back up to the monster code. Which I don't know if that's necessarily... I don't know if that's necessary, actually, with a lot of the stuff I found out. No, you know what? I think I tried to remove that, and it didn't work. Oh, geez, DN. Really? So then it jumps back up into where the monster code happens. Which, again, none of this should ever happen. Hey, Jenny for me. Thanks for the follow. That's my new... this is the first time I've actually gotten to show it off. That's what happens. That's what happens when I get a follower. Thanks to Twitch alerts. That was actually kind of cool to see. Anyway... What do you mean, what monster does he use? It doesn't use a monster at all. It doesn't use a monster at all. There's actually space in the, there's actually space for all of the regular characters to have, pointers to script monster scripts. Man, I am tongue-tied today. Yeah, there's space in the RAM for all of those things. So I wonder if it would be better, instead of relying on rage for all this stuff, to just have it check to see if the pointer is clear. Yes, that's how the game is current. That's how the game was set up, was that you had to take a monster slot for it. But the way I did it, you don't have to do that. And that RAM doesn't get used for anything else, as best as I'm aware. So, okay, so this 4C, this jump to the new location, that's this stuff here. That originally already appeared in here. So 3018x, 3A4A, 3255X. Branch of minus to 3052. So if it's minus, what's it jump back? Wait, 1, 2, 3. And then it goes into here. Okay, good. So I added a jump for that. So regular characters should be fine. They should get where they need to go. Hey, Crusader Bear, thanks for the follow. I like that people like that. That's working out for me. Well, yeah, that's what everyone thought when I was first going into this. And I was determined I was going to find a way, but all the stuff's there. All the things are there. The reason why it utilizes the monster scripts is so that it knows when to attack. Anytime, Crusader Bear. Anytime. So what we were looking at just up here in the ATB code is it needs to know when to attack. And the player characters will never enter the queue, the attack queue. And so I just had to write custom code to have them enter the attack queue when under the rage status. So it had to do with the way that they wrote the ATB code. Is the reason why they had to do that. Stop taking that off. All right. So all of this should work, and since no one is raged, this should never happen. Unless I've got the wrong address. And so depending on what the processor status is here, that should never run. So maybe it's running when it's not supposed to run and it screws something up somewhere along the line. So I'm gonna try to do these two changes, or technically this one change. Now this is also in the ATB code, but I'll get there. I'm just gonna do this one. Because if I'm looking at this correctly, it should never enter anywhere that should have a problem. I should be able to do this without creating the bug. All right, so that's what we're gonna do. So let's go to 26800 and it's about that long. What is this? That is not even the whole thing. I don't know what this is. That's wrong, though. Oh, you know what? That's the copied... That's this new stuff. This was the copied thing plus the jump. And let's make sure this all lines up with what it's supposed to. 4C... Oh! Hey, that's different. I have 5003 here. That stuff happens sometimes. Oh, I found a mistake. My jump for the characters, for the players that are not affected by rage, which this would happen. I'm glad I decided to do this. Jumps 2 bytes earlier. So instead of jumping to here, it's jumping to this DC02. I don't even know what opcode DC is. but it's running something, and I bet that might be it. Do I have, let me, where's the wiki? I want my opcodes. Why didn't I bookmark the opcodes yet? Bookmark this. No, come on, DC. Oh, come on. And I'm just dropping my microphone everywhere. Dropping my microphone, okay. Jump. Oh, no. That seems like that should blow up way more than it did. But whatever it's jumping to, oh, man. Oh, no. Jumps to an indirect address, too? Okay, I have a feeling this is a problem. I really want to trace this out. I want to see what this what happens here. All right. Before I fix this. Not here. I'm going to run that one. And we're going to run a breakpoint at C26600. All right. So you're not 3250. Oh, look, I've got EAs there. Why do I have EAs there? Huh. Well, that didn't cause a problem. Because I already had the other stuff. That means still wrong, but Oh man, I was hoping we had found it. But that does not look like that's the case. I should, however, make sure I did all these other ones right. Dagnabbit. Yeah, that probably would have been a much more severe break, so 4DCO2, right? O2DC. DCO2, 4CDCO2. Okay. Oh, I can just do it here. 303BD5532. 1C4A3A. I don't know why I'm going backwards. BD1830. Okay, so the rest of this is fine. It looks like I've got some more stuff up here, too, that I didn't use yet. This is also different. What do I have over there? You know what? Doesn't matter. Don't get sidetracked. I need to make changes in the right places. Go to 20535. Actually, this part isn't the part that's changed, is it? Let's go to the same point here. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Let's make sure it does the thing I said it would do. Difference doesn't happen until 4-5. Well, hold on a tick. Right here. BD. Which is this. Okay, sorry. Sorry, I had to get my head straight. All right. So BD F9 E3. So that's the status byte. Rotate. Is 6A even right? It's probably right. For some reason, okay, yes. Let's rotate right for the accumulator. Alright, 6A. BOED, branch of carry set. ED, and that should be FE 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D. So that should be jumping me down to 3, 7, right? 3, 3, 7, which is here right after that branch. I don't know what this is, but it's in the monster code, so I guess it should be there. 5, 7. Zero, three, 5, 7. Oh, you know what this is? This is probably checking for if the, No, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. We're gonna find out if that's the problem, though. Alright, and then it jumps to the new location. 4C0066. Okay. Alright. So we're gonna see if we break it. Okay, good. I didn't think it should be broken, so. I should not be hitting the wrong buttons. Alright, I think we're clear. Man, it's already 11 o'clock. Debugging is not always easy. Where am I? Yeah, they were. Okay. Well, I guess that means we're heading into the ATB code. Clack, 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 clack. Yeah. Alright. I amuse myself. Aw. Somebody's got to do it. Okay. Alright, so in the ATB code. Was this just me checking on something, or is that an actual change? Unfortunately, it's been like 2 months since I did this. 3218X, current ATB timer count. 3218, yep. I guess that was informational for me. Or maybe I started changing things right there. What's this and where did I put it? All right, so this is what we're gonna do. 6620. I feel like there's stuff that I didn't get. Yeah, that'd be smart. That would be smart. So, let me take both of these back to the beginning and start seeing what's different. I'm going to see where I'm starting to run into differences. So, C2-400. What is that? C2. That's not even a thing. Am I looking at the right thing? It should be C2 zero, oh, 6 0 600. Okay, the rage selection function. Yeah, that shouldn't be a problem, but I don't have this documented, so WTF. You know what? I think my code is actually split between here and my old document. Or something. Or you know what I was doing? I was restoring the old function. That's what it was. I think I was restoring the old function. Because you see the 7.5 copy, it jumps out to F2, which is where my old code was. And that is actually not there any longer. So that's why it's omitted from there. 2534B. Which is not what this looks like anyway. It does a totally different thing. 65DO. I'm going to finish the stuff on the document. I know it's getting late, but these are the prices we pay as hackers, right? All right, I need to figure out where this is. Whatever the heck this thing I'm doing here is. Go into here, right? And we're gonna find a hex value. Grab those, and then 6A. And then B015, and that should be enough. C211FO, which is really close to this. C211EF. EF, that's here. Okay, and so that's this. So why do I have this? Was this you know, this is probably what I was working from, maybe. Maybe this was the copy. Because then it goes BD05, which this doesn't do. Huh. Man, I'm bad at this. All right. What you're doing, check to see if it's monster, jumps directly into command queue. Right, that's the ATB stuff. And then I needed it to check for rage. Right. I wonder if loading A here at some point ruins things. All right. Okay. How far does that go? How far does it go wrong? Go to 213FO. So instead of, let's go like this. Quite a ways. Quite a ways, because I have all those EAs there at the end. I don't know if that code stands alone by itself. I don't think it does. 4C, this is at least attached to this here. This 6620 jump. So let's go get that. Go to 26820. Right, which is the next function that I stuck in there. Okay. Which maybe that's the, nope. The first thing it does is a jump, is a subroutine also. I think that jump must have been maybe restoring the stuff that was supposed to be there. Yeah, I don't know. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save it and I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna try it where we're at. Okay, stop. Stop it, stop it, stop it. And this is in the ATB code. Oh, we found it. We found it. Look at that, guys. We found what we're doing wrong. All right, so we need a breakpoint. Oh, thank goodness we found it. Okay. At 11EF, I think. So, let's do what we did last time and double check my code. Not that. This. And then this. Okay. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to... Okay. End of the ATB code. First, let's make sure I actually put in the right numbers. All right, 20B411, so that's jump to subroutine 11B4, so that's right. BD4D3E, which is a load for 3E4D with an offset of X. LSR, TXA, ROR, store 10. Load AO2 and jump. So I think maybe that's the stuff that... Yeah, this is, I think, the stuff that got lifted. Yeah, that got lifted out of here. So I wonder what 11B4 does. Just real quick, to make sure I'm not ruining it. It could be that something needs to be done here that I'm ruining with my code. And again, I apologize for how messy this is. Ideally, everything will eventually look... Ideally, all my stuff will look like this. Because this is a lot simpler to go through. But when I'm doing stuff for myself, I'm just, like, doing it. And then after it's done working, if I don't plan to, like, release it somewhere, then I'm generally like, okay, well, shove that in a folder and never look at it again. But then stuff like this happens... And I'm like, what was I thinking? All right, well, let's go back to here because this is where I started doing things different. Or somewhere, man, I don't even know. All right. So 213F3. So what did I put in there? BD F9E3. I have a feeling it has to do with this. I have a feeling it has to do with the fact that I'm loading A here. And then it branches to 120E. I don't know if that's right. Well, hold on a tick. Am I skipping stuff that I'm not supposed to skip? Let me get here. What am I supposed to have happen? Load A. So F3. It starts doing this stuff here. Which is that stuff that... No. That stuff I cover over here. So this stuff happens. Why do I have a branch of 15? Oh, if carry set, then it's going to go to the then the transcode. And if it's not set, then it continues on. And the first thing it does is load A. So that shouldn't be an issue. So the load A there shouldn't affect the load A here. Okay. Oh, see, I see. All right, monster jumps directly in command queue. And then character jumps directly into command queue if they have the right byte set. Okay, so do I have these? Do I have these properly? 213 EF. So EO08 BO1B BD F9 E3. Okay. 6A, BO15. Okay. And then I don't see how this affects anything. Branch if plus. And exits the function. I wonder if I moved these without changing the correct address. 10C2, is that what that's supposed to be? It's a BD0532, 10C2. So that got moved, but I didn't change the jump. That could affect things. Because that's not an F6 anymore. This is now an FD, so C2 goes to a totally different spot. Let's find out where it goes. 10C2, so that'd be... Okay, so I think I found it. This is like the 8th time I've said this, so take that with a grain of salt. It's be FEDC12. So right now it's dropping it to a TDC, which might be in the middle of an opcode. I don't know. Where it's supposed to go is 11BA. It's supposed to be going here. It's supposed to be exiting. Instead, it's jumping to clears everything out and does some other stuff, and it's a while before it gets out. But it's apparently not enough to break it. And this does run constantly. So I need to fix these. I can't believe I didn't see that, because that's a silly problem to have. That is a silly thing to overlook. Oops. All right, guys, give me 1 second. I'm going to wrap up here real soon because I think I found it. All right. I've got a good feeling about this one. Running a bunch of code when you're not supposed to be running any code, that's kind of a problem. All right. So this is where I'm at here, 10C2, and this 30BE. Both of those are supposed to go to an exit. Now, hypothetically, I could turn any of these into an exit, but I'm just going to go to the same one that they went to. Okay. But real quick, again, for fun, let's make sure I've got the game loaded. We're going to do a breakpoint at right here. So C211F9. And just well, let's take a look at what kind of crazy stuff we are running. Basically constantly. And the thing is, I have no idea what those are. But eventually, one of those is going to get run. It's just going to keep doing it. You know, I don't know how to make that trigger because I don't know what it is that it's loading. I kind of wanted to see where that played out, but it explains why it doesn't happen all the time because I don't know what the condition is. I don't even know what that's checking for. 3205X and B1. Either one of those being wrong. There's some sort of special condition. I don't know what they are, though. And I don't have a RAM map up. Let's do the battle RAM, and let's see what B1. I don't know what B1 is. I know B1 is used in, like, targeting and stuff, isn't it? But that's obviously not what this is talking about here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to fix these. So that C2 should be... Let's see. F-E-D... C. B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C. Should be B, C, right? I'm going to double check that real quick. F, E, D, C, B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C. Yep. So that C2 should be a B, C. Okay. And again, I've got this empty space here, so I could just put it right here. Or somewhere in the middle there. For some reason, it just feels wrong to do it. And that BE should be changed by a similar amount. It should be going to... Actually, it's probably also going to be a B something. F-E-D-C-B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8, 8, 6, B-8. F-D-E-C-B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, yes. Well, I think we found it. I cannot believe that, you know what, I can believe that I overlooked stuff like that. Oops. It actually does not surprise me in the least. All right, did I save that right? Help if I did that. All right, file, load game. And the great part is it didn't have to do with the functionality of my had nothing to do with the functionality of trance. So it's not like the way I wrote things caused problems. It was, I think we found it, guys. That is it. Woohoo! I solved a problem! So guys, that's what really debugging is all about. Okay? Debugging is about narrowing down your options. Right? It's about narrowing it down. So, just to recap, so that we can tie this up with a nice tidy bow. The first part was being able to replicate the results, okay? Being able to replicate the problem. Then you go back through your backups, your very well documented backups, and you find out where the problem began. Once you know where the problem began, you can check your notes to find out what you're looking at. From there, you can use your brain. Use your brain to try to figure out what things it could be and what things it couldn't be. Verify by making those changes. And then just go through each of your changes just a little bit at a time. You'll narrow it down because you have to. It's that simple. There's a finite number of things that it could be. So, I mean, I changed a lot of stuff in the last month and a half. Now, and not as much as maybe some other times, because I've been working on the magic update, but I made a lot of changes. Like, there were a lot of things that could have been wrong, seeing something as simple as this. And the thing is, I still don't even know what exactly it was doing to cause that problem. Like, I don't know what the code was. I don't know what was tying up the C1, getting it stuck in a giant loop. But whatever the specific thing was, ended up not mattering. It was this jumping into the middle of random code and running opcodes it was never meant to run. Okay? So you start with your problem, you go to your backups, and you go to each change one at a time until you replicate it, and then you just double check your code. You step through, you find where it's at. And we did it. We actually found the problem. So I'm pretty happy. Because there have been many nights where I ended my stream not having finished what I wanted to finish. So, bam. Bam. Alright, guys. Thank you for showing up. Thank you for coming tonight. I really appreciate it. I will see you next week. Alright? Happy hacking, and have a good one.